participate, all the faculty, everybody who is there to participate, please ask them because it's too late.
I request everyone to please stay back, and we have a good number of audience waiting for the queues in the...
Okay, no problem.
And I hand over the mic to Dr. Ashwath. Dr. Ashwath is familiar to all of you.
Yes. No prizes for faculty, please.
Faculty also can participate.
Can participate, but no prizes.
Okay.
All the prizes for the postgraduates.
If the faculty win the prizes, that prize will go to the organizing committee.
Yeah, part of organizing committee. Praises. He's not giving prizes, he's giving praises.
Anyway, we will start the quiz without delay. Shall I share the screen? Okay. Two minutes, I will tell you the quiz instructions. Okay, all of you, please take your mobiles. See, there should be a good internet connection. You should have two devices, a laptop which you are using it and a mobile, or you should have another mobile with you to answer the questions. The app Kahoot should be downloaded. So go to the Play Store or App Store and start downloading Kahoot app. It will take 1 minute only. You will see the questions on the laptop while you answer in your mobile. Okay. Maximum time taken is 30 seconds. I have made it 1 minute because the delay is there. Person answers fast will get more points. Even if all of you are correct also, the questions, because I want all the faculty, everybody to answer, most of them to enter. So I made it very simple, actually, the quiz. Quiz should be, and it's the fastest finger first. That is what. So this will look like this. When you go to the App Store or Play Store, it will Kahoot Play Quiz will be there. This sign will be there. Please, all of you. This 2 minutes is the only delay for it. Then it will be very fast. See, please, this is what. Please open. Okay, download and open it. Okay. Then what will you see is that once you have downloaded and you installed, and download, install, then you open it. Okay. When you open it, you will see such a picture. Welcome. Okay. So they will ask you, welcome, when it comes, they will ask you two quick questions. Okay. One will be, do you want to use Kahoot? As a student, you write. Even if you are a teacher here, my teachers are there. But today you should write student. Okay. Chandrika madam, join. So you should download and then as a student. Okay. Then the next is, they will ask you, what is your age? Nobody is going to see. Even I am not going to see. It is just a matter. Just they want to ask two questions. So you can put any age. Nobody is going to see. Once you have entered the age, then it will come to a picture like this, enter pin. See, this picture will come and below there will be something called a four-colored sign called enter pin. So you have to enter that pin, click there, then this will open it like this. This is what you will get now. See, all of you, game pin will, now I am going to give the game pin. It will take time. So once more, I am telling you, please, all of you listen. This is the most important part. All these instructions were given in the brochure. I don't know how many of you have downloaded. PGs would have downloaded definitely. Others, please download. So you should have two devices, a laptop and two separate mobile. App Kahoot has to be downloaded. You see the questions like in the Zoom, but you have to answer that in the mobile. Maximum time taken will be 30 seconds. In mobile, you will have that four colors. So in which color the answer is there, you just click that color. That is it. Person answered first will get more points. This is how it looks like. See, this is, you have to install Kahoot. And Bhagyalakshmi madam, installed Kahoot?
Yes.
Installed Kahoot. And then please open the Kahoot. Okay, open. When you open it, it will come like this. Welcome. And you can put next to it. Then, how do you want to use Kahoot, they will ask. So there, you should ask as a student. Then they will ask your age, letter, whatever age you want to put. Then a picture will come. You have to click enter pin. Once the pin will come like this. See, once you have entering the pin, then what will it show is that it will ask for your name. Surname it would have written, but you ask, put your right name so that we can give you prizes.
So what is the game pin that you will tell us now?
PGs, that is okay. Whoever gets the prize is open for all. Anyway, that Kunjimoidi.
No, the game pin.
A game pin will come now. See, okay. Now I am stop sharing and I am going to start the quiz. Okay. All of you, I have downloaded till then because now the quiz will go fast. That is why. Till this, you have done? Chandrika madam, you have done? Eldia? Ended? Okay. So I am going to stop share this and I am going to start the quiz. Okay. So. Pin varum. Pin vannu. 466-4898. Idaanu pin. പിൻ അടിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞ് നിങ്ങളുടെ പേര് എൻ്റർ ചെയ്യുക മൊബൈലിലേക്ക്. ആ ഭാഗ്യലക്ഷ്മി മാഡം, വീണ, ആ അതേ അതെ ആൾക്കാര്, കുഞ്ഞുമൊയ്തീൻ, ജിതേന്ദ്ര, then the students are entering.
That delay in seeing the other platform, it will be there. That's why.
That is why we have put the question. See, question as 1 minute actually. That is why. So if the organizers doesn't want to play, they can see the questions. Okay, and click only at the end answer. Bagalesh madam and all, click only at the end. Let students answer and then. You click.
Okay.
All the organizers click at the last when it comes to 60 seconds. You click at the last 10 seconds. Okay. So that let the students get the prize. Okay. Because you will be seeing all the 10 people who have entered initially will be seeing the questions 10 seconds before others. That is the only problem and it is in the two platforms. So one more minute I will wait. 33-34 people have logged in because I know that at this time of 9:40 at least 50 people logs in. It's a very big thing. So let us see anybody else logs in. Okay, it is logging in. 1 minute I will give you because after that the quiz will finish. 20 questions are there. Quiz will finish like this. 33-34 people have logged. Logged 38 now. It becomes 50, we will immediately start. Now also people are logging in. See, others can see the quiz. If you are not able to play also, no problem. So you can see and see the quiz and you can, in your mind, you can tell the answer there in the, so that you can see that you are correct or not. The thing is that all the 20 questions are easy. That is the reason. So you have to be, because I put it like that, then only the quiz becomes interesting. No use of putting very tough questions which nobody can answer. It has become 45. Now 20 seconds more. I am going to wait. Otherwise, I am going to start. 45 people have logged in. That is a good number. Without delay, I am going to start. All the best for all of you. Kunjimoidin, I am starting now. One more person has logged in. 46.
people can join in between or no?
Join in between. The thing is that, madam, what will happen is that they will not get praise.
Okay.
There, 2-3 questions have gone means the point is 1,000 points for each question is there. So that depending on that, so that much difference will come. So no problem. Anybody can join in between. They know the rules are there written in the our brochure. So looking at it, they can easily join. Anyway, it is too late. Otherwise, usually I have conduct with 2,000 people and all. FOGSI quizzes. 1,500. 50. The number magical. 51. Ah, people are joining. So anyway, no time because it's too late. I am going to start the quiz. Okay, you can join in between. No problem. I am starting.
You can start.
Start. Question is starting. Yes. First question. Very simple. All of the following are epithelial tumors except serous, endometrioid, fibroma, Brenner. Organizers, our team who is logged in the other, please answer late. Who are in the Zoom link. I want, we will answer in the last 10 seconds. Okay, because let the students answer first. It is just fun. Very simple questions. Fun. There are four types of ovarian tumors, which you know. Epithelial, germ cell, sex cord stromal, and metastatic. So you all know that it will come. Answer will come. 23 people have got it correct. It's a fibroma, which is a sex cord stromal tumor. So lack of time, I am not explaining too much. So Veena is leading. So identify this. Who is this personality? It's Ernest Wertheim, Frederick Shota, Okabayashi, and Harry Rich. That delay, that is why now the students will answer. That is why. So it comes to almost 30 seconds when the students answers. That is why last 10 seconds only our team who has logged in through the Zoom should answer. So it was Frederick Shota. And now you can see who is leading. Dr. Reshmi has overtaken now coming up. So it was not, it was like everybody would think that it's worth times. That is why I put this question. So he was in radical vaginal hysterectomy. Kyoto classification. Radical hysterectomy. What is level 2 lymph node dissection? External iliac, external and internal iliac knot, obturator knot, common iliac knots, aortic inframesenteric. Now the students will start answering the. So, you have different four levels actually. Four levels. Level 2, what is it? That is what we have asked. The answer is common iliac nodes. So to confuse, I put obturator. So external internal iliac obturator, then common iliac level 2, inframesenteric level 3, and supramesenteric level 4. So Vinodini has come up as the first. Let us see. mucinous tumor which has better sensitivity. I'm not telling it is the best. HE4, CA724, VGF, and OVX1, which has a better sensitivity. Actually, this all requires only 30 seconds, but due to this delay, I had to put it 1 minute. Otherwise, so you may think that it is, the people on Zoom may think that a very simple question, why it has kept 1 minute. That is the reason why it had to be pushed to 1 minute. So it is not HE4. HE4 is nothing to do with mucinous. So that is what I discussed also. Please, all the PGs, mucinous HE4 is nothing to do with mucinous. Okay. CA1 sensitivity better than it is 72.4. See, 99 and 72.4. Tejas has come up. In leiomyosarcoma, if the adenexia is involved, what is the stage? Simple. So, Anusmita has now come up. Who was the first person to describe the entity of hydatidiform mold? Entity of hydatidiform mold. Ian Donald, Hippocrates, Bagshaw, Newlands. Who described the entity of hydatidiform mold? Actually, it was Hippocrates. The hydatidiform mold was first diagnosed by Ian Donald because he found out invented the ultrasound. So after this, we can see continuously the people are changing who is getting the, okay. Identify this. What is this? Karl Exner bodies, Schiller dual bodies, signet ring cell, Samoma bodies. Somehow the spelling is wrong. P is there. Sorry. All are things which you have seen only. See, today, these are all shown by different faculty. I have not put anything else. Everything is discussed. Everything is discussed. It's Carl Exner body. Schiller-Duval bodies are seen in endodermal sinus tumor. Okay. Signet ring cell, clear cell, the summama bodies in papillary serous. Here again changes there. Pina has again come up. Next question. If a 2.5 centimeter from the source of radiation receiving a dose of 1,000, okay. 5 centimeter from the source of will receive how much radiation? See, if a 2.5 centimeter from the source of radiation, see, imagine there is a source of radiation receiving 1,000. 2.5 centimeter from that will receive how much radiation? It has a radiation has a low. That is what I just wanted to project here. It's called the inverse square law. So that is the reason why it is 250. Otherwise, it would have been 500. Okay. So inverse square law. Again, Veena is maintaining the lead. Let us see. Of the ovarian tumors, which is the most radiosensitive tumor. In ovarian tumor, which is the most radiosensitive tumor. Embryonal carcinoma, endodermal sinus tumor, choriocarcinoma, dysgerminoma. Which is the most radiosensitive tumor? Radio sensitivity doesn't mean that that is a treatment for that tumor. Okay. Actually, in this most radio sensitive dysgerminoma, why we are not giving? It's an adolescent tumor. If you give, the fertility goes. So in a dysgerminoma, we go for fertility sparing surgery and chemotherapy, BEP regime. So Reba has again overtaken. Identify this. Simple hyperplasia, complex hyperplasia, atypical hyperplasia, endometrial carcinoma. These are all classical pictures which you see in your books. I have taken this from Novak, so nobody can say that they have not seen. Because during this presentations, you would have naturally discussed all these things. Now we don't have the old classification. Now we have different types of classification that we have only atypical and non-atypical only nowadays. And previously EIN came, then again the same. With atypia, without atypia, that's it. So, it is atypical endometrial hyperplasia and Reba is maintaining the lead. We are going for the next. Very simple. IVP shows hydronephrosis in the workup of cervical cancer, which is the stage. You have done an IVP, it is showing an hydronephrosis. These are all common things what we see. That is what clinical points which I put, clinically what you see. Then what does it mean? When you do an IVP or we do an ultrasound, it is showing. Nowadays, we don't do IVP routinely. The IVP was a previous investigation, but most of the time, ultrasound may be enough anyway, naturally, we will do an MRI. Definitely will show this hydronephrosis in a workup. So that means that it is it has involved the So anyway, let everybody answer. So nothing. So whenever the basically which stage the ureter is involved, whenever the parametrium is completely involved, the ureter is involved. That's what. So the answer is everybody got, most of you got it correct. It would have been very simple question. So Reba is maintaining the lead. You are going fast. What percentage of, this is one question which is asked for always exams. What percentage of dermoid cysts are bilateral? See, dermoid cyst, you all know, has a tendency to be bilaterality. That is why whenever you do scan and do laparoscopy for dermoid cysts, we always tell the sonologist to see the other ovary also. Otherwise, after doing laparoscopy for one ovary, after 6 months, the patient will come back with dermoid cysts in the other ovary. Even if a good sonologist can detect small dermoids. So many times we have bilateral dermoids, I have removed many times. So what is this bilaterality? This is one case which is asked in the exam. What is the, and dermoid cyst is a short note also. It's a 10 mark question when you are asked dermoid cyst. It's otherwise called the benign cystic teratoma. Teratomas can be divided into two. And it's called the benign cystic teratoma. So almost all of you have got it correct. So still now, Reba and Veena are maintaining their lead. See, what is the first gynecological cancer to be staged? CA cervix, CA ovary, CA endometrium, CA vulva. So which was the first gynecological cancer to be staged? Simple things. So CA cervix, that also most of you know. You orient Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. It contains so many things, hematomas, angiomas. But 10 to 15% of the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome is associated with an ovarian tumor. Okay. So, whenever a patient with Peutz-Jeghers syndrome comes, you have to search, do a ultrasound and search for. So, which type of ovarian tumor is commonly seen in Peutz-Jeghers syndrome? Dysgerminoma, a sex cord stromal tumor, Krukenberg tumor, or endodermal sinus tumor? So this is another, when you are part of a syndrome, so you have to know that there is something called so this is sex cord stromal tumor. Let us see what is happening, any change. Men carrying BRCA1, BRCA2 are at risk of which cancer? Testicular cancer, prostate cancer, pineal cancer, anal cancer. We are going to the last 5 questions. Next 5 minutes, we will end the quiz. Everybody be fast and answer. Questions are simple. This is just to tell you, this question was to tell you that BRCA is that not only, we all know, I didn't tell you that BRCA1 40%, BRCA2, 20% for ovary, and BRCA1 and 2 for breast when you have to tell 80%. So that is how you calculate, okay. So prostate cancer, most of you have got it correct. So the remaining, this 10-year-old female presented with a polypoidal vaginal mass protruding through the introitus. Okay. So it is it rhabdomyosarcoma? Is it a vaginal clear cell sarcoma, carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma, or a sarcoma botryoides? While in a cancer hospital, when I was working, I saw this case years back in GCRI. At that time, I saw this case, such a case. So everybody knows it is sarcoma botryoides. Again, the last four questions. God's, which cancer is known as God's first cancer, man's first cure? Is about which cancer? God's first cancer, man's first cure. Which cancer is called the God's first cancer, man's first cure? Because this cancer is complete, almost completely curable. That is the reason why. Answer is choriocarcinoma, most of you got. Last three questions. Another very simple question. Which cancer may be seen in genetically predisposed women after prophylactic salpingogenophorectomy? Say, for example, a BRCA1, BRCA2 patient, you are doing prophylactic salpingogenophorectomy. Okay. Are you free of cancer? That is what the question. Is there any chance of any other cancer? Like hepatic carcinoma, gastric carcinoma, peritoneal carcinoma, appendicular carcinoma, any other cancer that this females can have? After this, only two more questions are there. We will come to the end of the quiz. I had yesterday also planned. This was, and today's questions were tough. Yesterday's was a simple round like this. So, but the lack of time, we will play in another conference. Okay. Okay, it's peritoneal, primary peritoneal carcinoma. Coming to only two more questions. Who discovered colposcopy? Papnicolaou, Henselman, William Coleman, Hawkins. Who discovered colposcopy? So it is Henselman. And the last question, There is no change. Veena and Reba. And the last question of the day, identify this. This is also a colposcopy picture. Punctation, condyloma, trichomonas infection, chlamydia infection. Come on, everybody, be fast. It's the last question. Those who are the winning three people has to contact Kunjumaydeen. Okay, so they have to contact Kunjumaydeen, send and collect their gifts, whatever he has planned. Okay, so please see that today itself after the quiz, you should contact him. Bhagyalakshmi madam, goi. So we come to the end of the quiz, and who is the winner? We will see. The podium has come. Three. Tejas SV has got third. Reba second. And Veena. And Anisha and Madhavi, fourth and fifth. Anisha and Madhavi, fourth and fifth. Kunjumaydeen, you have written Anisha and Madhavi, fourth and fifth, if you want to give. Anisha and Dr.
Actually, we will not be giving to faculty.
Okay. So, Anisha and Madhavi, fourth and fifth. So, you write that and give to them. Anisha and Madhavi. Write Anisha and Madhavi, fourth and fifth.
Veena is our faculty. Veena is faculty, no?
Veena, there are two Veenas. I don't know this Veena is a faculty or not.
I really don't want the prize. I just wanted to participate. So please give it to the person.
Very good. Okay.
Congratulations. Okay.
Veena, congrats actually. It is not a...
Thank you. Nice quiz. So, I really enjoy quizzes actually.
So you can give to Anisha. So first Reba. Reba first. Tejas second and Anisha third. Anisha third.
No, we have 2/3 actually.
Anisha and we can put Anisha and Madhavi third.
Yes.
In between, I lost contact with Kahoot.
Otherwise, madam, you would have to delete one more person.
No, it's okay. Just nice to
message the winners. You can contact the mobile number which I am giving now. You can contact Mr.
Okay, thank you, Moedin. I will take it.
Mr. Vasim at 85 89 075075.
So, she's from Jipmer, Reba.
No, let me tell the number, madam. 85 89 075075. That's the number, or you can write to POGSKerala@gmail.com. With your copy of the identity card and the copy of an government approved ID card. So with these two details, the first ID card is the institutional ID card. The second is the government approved ID card. So these two things you can mail to pogskerala@gmail.com. We'll move on to the last lab. Ashwath, it was a very fantastic quiz program. Everybody
really endorse it. It was fantastic.
Yeah, enjoyed very well. And I feel sad that yesterday we couldn't have the program, but because we got later on for 2 hours yesterday. Altogether, we are receiving a very good feedback from the delegates who are attending the meeting. And really sincere thanks to Bhagyalakshmi madam for giving us this opportunity and helped us to conduct this program. And express our sincere thanks to FOGSI President Dr. Alpesh Gandhi sir, who came and inaugurated the program. Dr. Mandagini ma'am, who has helped us to facilitate to get the ICOG credit points. And the Vice President in charge of the Oncology Committee, Dr. Anita Singh. And the KFOG leaders, Dr. Ambujam and Dr. Venugopal. And my own team members, the chief advisors, Dr. Ashwath and Dr. Muralidhar Pai, who have given sufficient advices to conduct this program in a successful way. And the patrons like Dr. Santosh Kuriakos, who also was very much helpful. And our own organizing team, the scientific chairperson, Dr. Mumtaz, the organizing secretary, Dr. Wahab, and the very active members of the organizing committee, Dr. Jitendra. And moreover, our coordinators, Dr. Leta, Dr. Reshmi, Dr. Pramila, and who else? Dr. Ajit and Dr. Sati, who have coordinated all the sessions, who have coordinated with the faculty very well. And last but not the least is the delegates who have stayed back with us till this last moment. And moreover, to make this event a grand success, the technical platform provided by the MedCon events and the people who have coordinated from behind the screen, Mr. Vasim and Mr. Arun. And I really express sincere thanks to all of you. Bhagyalakshmi, madam, would you like to mention a few words?
Yes, I think I'll express my heartfelt thanks to all of you from Kerala, Dr. Aswath, you and Dr. Chandrika, Dr. Senagal, and all the esteemed teachers who have spent their time to be here with us. And more than that, I think all the postgraduates. So in case it's possible for all of us to get some kind of feedback so that the next time we can make it much better. So I forgot to tell you, we should have put a link for the feedback. Also, so that next time we could improve on that section,
madam, that I'll forward it to you.
Okay. So I think it was a fantastic work, and I think it was a collaborative work with so many people working for you, and I really hats off to you and your leadership quality. So I have experienced it before and again this time also. So thank you so much again for taking gynec oncology so ahead, because people think only infertility and laparoscopy is the end thing. So now I think people will have a little interest in gynec oncology as well.
It will be so crazy.
Thank you so much.
Hope so. And anybody else,
for my postgraduates, if any of them are there, that the cervical cancer rates have gone up. This GlobalCan 2020 data has come and the rates have gone up in India, and it's more than China this time. So we have to really gear up to control it. So as Dr. Alpesh Gandhi has told, we all have to be preventive oncologists. We don't need gynae oncologists. We need preventive oncologists. So thank you again so much, Dr. Kojimaitan.
Yeah. Dr. Ashwath?
Kunjumaydeen, it was so nice actually. See, as madam told, the importance of gynecology, and as a infertility specialist, I don't know how you took a different topic. And it is done. And see, when you are doing something which is not your cup of tea, and in doing so nicely, that is Kunjumaydeen, madam. So I know him. He was my senior in my college. I know whatever he takes it to do it with full sincerity to it.
Exactly.
So see, and he sat in, madam, did you see? Even he is not going to see a single oncology case, but he sat the 2 days. That is what I observed. Full. You cannot imagine. I was thinking, even I was logging in and out. So Kunjumaydeen was sitting there. See, even I am practicing gyneo-oncology. I am sitting means it's for my benefit. So it is nothing. He is full encouraging all juniors, all the faculty, everybody sending messages.
And the program was flawless.
Flawless. What is it? Yeah. It is so good. No complaints. Anybody had no complaints. Nothing. Little. See, this is program was good. That is why it prolonged. And the people are sitting. Can you imagine? 50 people at the end participated or quiz at 10 o'clock. So in which conference you will get? Okay. So thank you.
I think this is the advantage of being virtual, because if you would have arranged it at Perathalmana, maybe we would have got 200. Yeah. But I think because it was virtual, so
may not be that much also for the faculty.
Yes.
Also.
Yes.
For the attention of the
delegate. And we got so fantastic faculty because it was online. It would have been difficult for us to get them for the real thing.
And for the attention of the delegates, the certificates can be downloaded, and the download link will be sent to all the delegates who have attended the conference through the delegate platform. And at the end, I request the event team to share the Janaganamana video. Arun, you can share.
Jana Gana Mana Vidyo.
So thank you. Good night to all. We'll see you again.
Yes.
Good night.
Thank you so Good night, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Ashwat, for being there and being the icing on the cake.
Yeah, and all the recordings can be shared in the group so that you can share to the PGs so that it should be useful to them for their exam preparation.
Okay, thank you. I'll just talk to FOGSI in case we can upload this on the FOGSI website. I think it will be a great help.
Yeah, definitely, ma'am. I'll send all the videos to you also.
Okay, thank you so much.
And, major things I'll share to you.
Good night. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, Lata, so much for being such a help.
No, I haven't done anything. Enjoyed.
Yeah.
Bye.
Last year Pondicherry was fantastic.
I know. We were remembering everything.
Yeah, and
your
nice coffee.
Next year we will have the hybrid meeting.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. That small place like Perinthalmanna, people can we can organize such events. Otherwise, I think we may not have thought about organizing this program at all in Perinthalmanna because of the difficulty in commuting to this place.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good night.
Bye.
Good night. Thank you. Bye.